A very good morning to all of you. So myself Neha Gupta, your mentor for current affairs, and I'm back with the video for February 4th, 2021. So in this video, I have a lot of questions for you guys and the people who were complaining to me that, ma'am, you should increase the questions in the video. For them, this video is going to be the answer of your question. So in this video, if this video stretches a little long, then you guys can't complain to me because it for you only that had told me to increase the number of questions. And believe me, the questions are interesting and important for your examination. So it's my guarantee that you won't get bored during the video. So let's begin this video, which is going to be very useful for your RBI, SEBI, NABARD, and banking examinations at the level of PO. But before that, those people who are coming for the first time, guys, subscribe and hit this bell notification. Also, you can join this Telegram group. Here we provide you with the latest current of latest quizzes as well as resolve your queries if you have any query related to exam or any query related to your career. So that query will be resolved on this channel and the link is in description below. So we have our first question about a scheme, which is a state scheme. And let me tell you that in this question, we have around 3 to 4 state schemes. And yeah, यहाँ पर I would like to warn you guys, state schemes are also very important from your exam point of view. And in Spotlight Magazine, these state schemes are covered very concisely in accordance with the examination. So do listen to me very carefully and read the Spotlight thoroughly. Okay, so the first question is, which state has launched Pragyan Bharati scheme to provide financial assistance to students for the purchase of textbooks and for their admissions? So basically, the simple purpose of this Pragyan Bharati scheme is to provide financial assistance to the students so that they can have an encouragement towards knowledge and they can gain knowledge. Or basically, we can say to arouse their interest in the education sector, this scheme has been launched by the state. And which state is it? We have Punjab, Haryana, Assam, Uttar Pradesh, and Madhya Pradesh in the options. The right answer is Assam. Apart from this Pragyan Bharati scheme, one more scheme has been launched by Assam government, and that scheme is Bhasha Gaurav. Bhasha is language, Gaurav is pride. So this scheme is the scheme pro aims to provide financial assistance to the literary societies, the Sahitya Sabhas, as well as the writers of the state, so that the literary culture of the state can be promoted. So that's the whole purpose of this Bhasha Gaurav scheme. So literary culture promotion is the aim of this scheme, and Pragyan Bharati aims to promote knowledge and to increase, arouse the interest of students in the knowledge sector. This scheme has been launched by the Assam government. Who is the CM and governor of Assam? Tell me in the comment section below. Next question is, which state has launched the mega surface water supply scheme for improving water quality and resolve the problem of arsenic affected water? So basically, this mega surface water supply scheme has been launched in order to provide the better quality water for drinking purpose and for other purposes of the household. So this scheme aims to replace the groundwater that is being used by the people at present with the surface quality water. Now, which state has launched this scheme? It is launched by Punjab. And let me remind you guys, this scheme is funded by four agencies. So these are the four sources of budget, or sorry, four sources of finance that this scheme has. So World Bank, Jal Jeevan Mission of the central government, NABARD organization, and state budget of Punjab. These are the four sources from where this scheme is drawing its funds. So therefore, this scheme is important because World Bank is involved here. So you have to remember the basic purpose of this scheme. And what is the basic purpose? To replace the groundwater with the surface quality water, as well as to improve or resolve the query of arsenic affected water. What is this arsenic affected water? Basically water which has high quality of arsenic. And this chemical or this element is harmful for human health. It can cause cancer and other diseases as well. Therefore, it is a very high alert. It is a very high emergency that the government should work towards eliminating this arsenic affected water. So that is the whole scheme. Now guys, apart from this, there is one more scheme launched by the Punjab government for water only, and that scheme is Har Ghar Pani. Har Ghar Safai. So basically this scheme aims to provide 100% potable drinking water by the year March 22. So this Har Ghar Pani, Har Ghar Safai aims to provide 100% potable drinking water to households by the year 2022. March is the month, is the deadline of this Har Ghar Pani, Har Ghar Safai scheme. And that's all for this question, that's all for the for this news. Next is, which company has manufactured the Star Dust 1.0, world's first commercial space launch powered by biofuel? So basically it's a launch vehicle. Stardust 1.0 is a launch vehicle, is a rocket that is powered by biofuel. So therefore this is an important question, because it is the world's first rocket that is fueled by the biofuel, and it is environment friendly too. Therefore there are high chances that a question can come upon it. Now, where was this launched? It was launched from US. So mine is the state from where this Stardust 1.0 rocket has been launched. Now, which company has manufactured this world's first satellite, which is world's first launch vehicle, which is powered by the biofuel? Which company is it? It's option D, Blue Shift Aerospace. So remember the company guys, this is important question because it is the world's first biofuel satellite. Now this reminds me to ask you that which country is manufacturing or is planning to launch the world's first Wooten satellite. This question guys I have talked about in the recent videos in the SEBI grade A revision series as well. So therefore I expect an answer from you guys. Tell me that which country is planning to launch world's first wooden satellite by 2023. This is your question. Next is, who is the editor of Dalai Lama's The Little Book of Encouragement? So this is a very famous book. Dalai Lama is a very famous personality, and therefore the editor of this book has been asked from you. So here you have to pay attention to the most famous books that are mentioned in the Spotlight magazine and the facts related to those books. Now the question is asking you about the editor of this book. Who is the editor? It's Renuka Sen. But that's all. These were the facts related to this book, and nothing else is given in the magazine as well as in the news as well. So do memorize the facts that I tell you in Morning Tales as well as in the Spotlight magazine. Okay. Again, we have the state initiative. Which state has launched a first of its kind initiative in the country to automatically select beneficiaries for old age pensions that will be paid through the direct benefit transfer mode? So basically what this question is trying to say is that there is a state that has launched an initiative that will automatically select the old age pension beneficiaries, and the pension will be provided to them through the direct benefit transfer mode. Now guys, you would be thinking that how is the government planning to locate the beneficiaries? What is the mode? What is the portal? What is the application through which this beneficiaries will be selected? So the app is Navodaya. Navodaya is the name of the app. Now we have discussed the app. Now let us know the name of the state. So the state is Karnataka. Karnataka has launched this first of its kind initiative, under which automatically the beneficiaries will be selected and DBT, through DBT, the pensions will be credited to their accounts. Do remember the name of the app through which the beneficiaries will be selected. Which state has launched agricultural pump power connection policy 2020 to provide uninterrupted power supply to the farmers in the state? So basically the purpose of this agricultural pump power connection policy 2020 is given in the question itself, that is to provide uninterrupted power supply 24/7 to the farmers. Now which state has launched this scheme? We have Sikkim, Bihar, Uttar Pradesh, Punjab and Maharashtra in the options. What is the right answer? Right answer is Maharashtra. Maharashtra has launched this policy, and along with this policy, Maharashtra government has also given some relief to the farmers in connection with the electricity bills. So their electricity bills arrears, the interest on their electricity bills dues have been waived off by the state government. And there are other some minor benefits that have also been given by the state government that are not at all important from your exam point of view. The important thing is right in front of you, that is the agricultural pump power connection policy 2020, and the purpose is this. So that's all for this question. Now we are on our next question. What is the name of the initiative launched by India to deliver the vaccines to neighboring countries? Very interesting question it is. So India is giving vaccines to other countries, and now you have to name the initiative under which this is being done. Like we have the Mission Sagar, under which the Indian Ocean region's countries will be covered, and those countries will be given the assistance in terms of medicines, foods, food, etc. Similarly, this initiative has also been launched, under which vaccines will be provided to the neighboring countries. Now you have to name the initiative. So we have Vaccine Abhera, Vaccine Abhagyam, Prasar, Maitri, Bandhuta. What is the right answer? The right answer is option D, Vaccine Maitri. Under this Vaccine Maitri initiative, India has already given vaccines to more than 7 countries. And why is this initiative in the news? The reason behind this is that, first reason is this, because it was launched on January 20, 2021, so it's a very recent initiative. And second reason is that Sri Lanka has been included in this Vaccine Maitri initiative. So Sri Lanka will be given vaccines under this initiative. Now which vaccine will we provide to these countries? We have two vaccines at present in the country which are being used by the government. First is Covaxin and second is Covidshield. Covaxin is produced by Bharat Biotech and Covidshield is given by Serum Institute of India. Out of these two, which vaccine will be provided to the Sri Lanka country? That is your question that you have to tell me in the comment section below. Which vaccine will be given to Sri Lanka under this Vaccine Maitri initiative? So we have the next question, which is, what is the name of the alliance launched by World Economic Forum to achieve the goal of equitable and affordable access to digital opportunities for everyone by the year 2025? We have Edison, Essential, Escalate, EduTech, Expand. In the options, what is the right answer? The right answer is option A, Edison. Now guys, why is this in news? What is the importance of Edison and what is the purpose? That I will discuss a little later, but I have another question related to World Economic Forum that I want to discuss first. So the next question is, who is the author of Stakeholder Capitalism book? Now you would be thinking, why is this related to World Economic Forum and how is it related to World Economic Forum? So the reason behind this is that this book has been written by the chairman and founder of World Economic Forum. Now guys, can you tell me that who is the author of this book? The right answer is option D, Klaus Schwab. He is the chairman and founder of World Economic Forum and the author of this book, which was launched during World Economic Forum's Davos Agenda Summit 2021. Now you don't have to panic guys, because I am going to discuss the highlights of the Davos Agenda Summit 2021 in the next slide, and also you will get to know the importance of Edison while I will be discussing the highlights of World Economic Forum, because Edison was launched during the Davos Agenda Summit only. So now we are on our slides on our explanation. World Economic Forum's Davos Agenda Summit 2021 has concluded on 29th January. Theme of the summit was a crucial year to rebuild trust. Headquarters of World Economic Forum, Geneva, Switzerland. So these are the some basic facts of Davos Agenda Summit. So these are the highlights. This is the first highlight. This Global AI Action Alliance was launched during World Economic Forum's Davos Agenda Summit. And remember guys, this Davos Agenda Summit was held virtually. Now what is this Global AI Action Alliance? AI refers to artificial intelligence. And in one line, I would like to sum up this entire paragraph. And the one line is, that the purpose of this AI Action Alliance is to use artificial intelligence sustainability for the benefit of society. That is the whole purpose of this Global AI Action Alliance. Basically, under this alliance, different stakeholders like government, innovators, etc., etc., will be put together, will be brought together, and these innovators, these stakeholders will try to figure out the ways in which artificial intelligence can be adopted for the benefit of society. So that is the meaning of this paragraph. Now in this second paragraph, you have been given some data given by World Economic Forum. So according to World Economic Forum, artificial intelligence has the potential of contributing 14 trillion to the global economy by 2035. And apart from this economic benefit, artificial intelligence has tremendous potential to improve the lives of various people. Therefore, artificial intelligence is a growing nascent field in which World Economic Forum aims to go further. Now guys, this point is very, very important. We have one alliance. Obviously, we need people to run that alliance. So there would be a steering committee which will be chaired by Arvind Krishna, Chairman and CEO of IBM, and Vilas Dhar, President of Patrick J. McGovern Foundation. These two people are chairing the committee that will be managing this Global AI Action Alliance. So that's all for this first highlight. We have 2-3 highlights as well. So stay tuned till the end. This is not the end. Okay. So guys, this is the Edison platform. World Economic Forum has launched this first of its kind alliance to achieve the goal of equitable and affordable access to the digital opportunities. According to World Economic Forum, you would be amazed to know that 50% of the world was offline during the COVID era. So that is a very shocking figure, I would say, because 50% of the world is offline. So it highlights the need to increase the digital penetration, and for that only this Edison network has been launched. Now this platform has a full form. What is the full form? Essential Digital Infrastructure and Services Network. This full form, guys, you have to remember, a question can come up on this as well in your upcoming RBI grade B exam. Apart from this, the other important point is this alliance too has a board that will lead this alliance, and the board will be chaired by Hans Westberg. He is the chairman of Verizon's Verizon company, chairman and CEO. The book launch, we have discussed the question, stakeholder capitalism, a global economy that works for progress, people and planet. So this is the subtitle of the book. It was launched. Its author is Klaus Schwab, who is the founder and executive chairman of World Economic Forum, and the co-author is Peter Denham. Co-author is important. This you have to remember, because co-author can also be asked in the examination. Okay guys, so this is the last highlight of World Economic Forum's Davos Agenda Summit, but not the last question, not the last thing that we are going to discuss. I have many questions ahead of this slide, so stay tuned till the end. Okay, so this World Economic Forum's uplink platform. Let me summarize this entire paragraph for you. Uplink platform is nothing but a platform where different innovators and the people who can implement the innovative solutions are brought together so that the sustainable development goals can be achieved. So on the one hand, we have innovators, we have entrepreneurs that can just have the innovative solutions, that can provide the innovative solutions. But on the other hand, we have the government, we have the policymakers, investors that can implement those solutions. So what does Uplink platform do? The Uplink platform brings together these two stakeholders so that the sustainable development goals can be achieved easily. That is the whole purpose of this Uplink platform. Now guys, why is it in the news? During the Davos summit, it was announced that around 10,000 innovators have joined this network. So this is why it is in the news. Now the point that you have to remember is this Uplink is designed and developed by Salesforce and Deloitte. So this platform is designed by Salesforce and Deloitte. This is the point that you have to remember. That's all guys. World Economic Forum's Davos Agenda Summit has ended. You have to remember the theme of that summit as well. People often tend to forget the themes of various summits. This mistake, guys, you don't have to do, because themes are important, and the summit which has so many important launches, the theme of that summit is obviously important. You can yourself judge that. Okay. Now we have the biography. Who is the author of the biography of Soumitra Chatterjee? First of all, who is this person? Why is it so important that we are discussing his biography? This person is a multitasker, is a multi-talented actor, poet, painter and whatnot. So in the month of November 2020, he passed away, and he is also a receiver of Dada Saheb Phalke Award, and which is a very prestigious award in the film fraternity. So therefore, this person is important. Now his autobiography has been released. And the authors of his autobiography are Arjun Sengupta and Parth Mukherjee. So the right answer is option both A and B. So what is the title of this, of his biography? This is your question that you have to find out and tell me in the comment section. That's all guys. This video ends here. I hope that you have enjoyed the video, and if you have, then do share it with your friends and do like this video. Thank you so much for watching the video.